Merci, Cody, pour cette introduction. This team, Cody, Sean, Darren, Lena, never stops standing up for Nova Scotians. I want to begin by recognizing Chief Peters. Thank you, Sid, for being here, and Sarah Rosenblatt. And a big shout out, of course, to Corey and Darlene for welcoming us to their beautiful farm. This province is known for a lot: hospitality, stunning coasts, commitment to the people around you, to neighbors, to community. Of course, the other thing you're known for is, frankly, those strong, gusty winds. Well, today, we're taking further steps to harness that power, to create jobs, to power homes, and to keep our air clean. I can announce that under conditional approval, we're investing about $255 million to build wind turbines and innovative battery storage projects across Nova Scotia. This is a huge step forward, and not just for the environment. Take the Red Spruce Wind Energy Project. It'll be here in East Hants, just over there actually, developed in partnership with Glooskap First Nation. The project will generate clean electricity and create good jobs. And that's just one of many in this investment. By harnessing Nova Scotian innovation and, yes, wind, we're creating over 500 middle-class jobs across the province. We're working in partnership with local First Nations communities, and we're delivering clean, made in Nova Scotia power to hundreds of thousands of homes. L'investissement dans l'énergie éolienne qu'on annonce aujourd'hui montre encore une fois que l'environnement et l'économie vont ensemble. On crée des emplois tout en luttant contre les changements climatiques. C'est une situation où tout le monde est gagnant. And as Cody pointed out, here in more rural parts of Canada, there is a deep understanding that creating cleaner air, fresher water, protected soils, sustainable practices is the only way to make sure that next generations on farms like this, but also across our country and cities, are going to have the kind of future we want for them. Rural Canadians have always been leaders in thinking about this, in pushing on this, and it's up to all of us to make sure we give the tools and investments that allow them to follow up on their big dreams. Of course, turbines are great for when the wind is blowing, but as it usually is, but what about days like today? How do we store all the energy they generate? The answer, of course, is batteries. As part of this investment, we're supporting construction of one of North America's largest battery systems right here in Nova Scotia. In fact, the turbines behind us helped power the pilot project leading to the development of these batteries. On investit à partir du captage de l'énergie éolienne jusqu'à son stockage et à sa distribution dans les foyers. Avec la Nouvelle-Écosse tous ensemble, on continue de bâtir un avenir propre. Here today, we're reminded that the solution to so many challenges our world faces is not what we don't have, but what we do have. Nova Scotia's got innovation, hard work, and a deep commitment to the world we're leaving for our kids. That's what will power our future.